Ezra Bridger and Harrison Dula have finally made it to the world of Yavin 4, following a lengthy journey after surviving the fall of Lothal. What should have been a heartwarming homecoming, however, was just the opposite. A few days prior, the pair received grim news from Saw Gerrera concerning plans the Empire had been working on under the name Stardust. Whether there was truth to this news or not, if it was to be believed that the Empire had a weapon capable of destroying planets in a single blast, the Rebellion needed to be alerted. As the Ghost got closer to Yavin 4's orbit, Hera tuned the ship's signal to the encrypted frequency used by the Rebellion, and a voice immediately came through.
VZX-100 Light Freighter, please halt and identify yourself.
Hera responded back that this was the Ghost, and it was her and Lieutenant Commander Ezra Bridger on board the ship. There was an extended pause from the other end of the transmission. Hera knew exactly why, and was ready for what was to come next.
Pilot of VZX-100 Light Freighter, transmit clearance codes immediately.
The response was harsh, almost as if the trooper was ready to open fire on whoever he believed dared to impersonate a fallen general. But once the codes came through, general shock ran through his body. There was a brief moment of relief as the Ghost flew over the jungles of Yavin 4. Despite the dark history of the planet, seeing the Rebellion that has gathered here reminded both Hera and Ezra that not everything had been lost. Once the ship landed, they had a renewed purpose to take the fight to the Empire. But the situation with Saw needed to be addressed first. A group of rebel soldiers all gathered around the Ghost, but Hera put an early end to the small celebration. She needed to talk with Rebel Command immediately. She was told the only commander available at the moment was Senator Mon Mothma, but that was all she needed. Senator Mon Mothma. Ezra stepped up. He could feel his heart pounding like a neck suit was clawing into his chest. We've learned something that could be really bad. Mon Mothma looked at Ezra and could tell he was horrified at something, and in her best way, tried to ease the news from the young Jedi. We talked to Saw Gerrera on the way here, and we know that you both don't see eye to eye, but he's found out something big, really big. Mon Mothma had her emotions change at the mention of Saw Gerrera, as Ezra was definitely right about them not seeing eye to eye. Saw had turned into an extremist, and in part, a lot of information from him couldn't be trusted. However, she knew that if Ezra and Hera felt there was some truth in it, it was worth the listen. He said that the Empire is making a new weapon, one that can destroy entire planets. He said that's why the Geonosians were all killed and why the Empire started capturing Wookiees. It all has to do with this. He said it was called Stardust. Mon Mothma could see the fear, and quite frankly, she found herself becoming fearful as well. This was too much to be true. But then again, the idea of falling under the crushing hand of an empire was the same so many years ago. She comes up with the idea of contacting Gerrera to ask him about this new information. However, multiple attempts to contact the partisan fell on dead silence. Suddenly, a communications officer ran up to the senator with startling news. Imperial comms are scattering with chatter, Senator. There's been reports of a skirmish in the streets of Jedha. Ezra and Hera knew what was happening. Jedha, that's where Saw is right now. He's looking for some guy. Krennic, that was his name. The communication officer has haunting news to back that up. Krennic is on Jedha right now, Senator. Mon Mothma looked stunned. Open conflict with the Empire is coming closer and closer, and she fears the Rebellion is not yet ready. She decides to send a detachment of fighters to aid, but ground troops will be reserved. She then turns to Hera, asking if she would be willing to join the fight. Hera turned to Ezra, who nodded his approval, and she was more than willing to head back to Jedha. The streets of Jedha were filled with combat. It seems as though Saw Gerrera sent every single soldier he had into the crowded streets. AT-STs did their best to maneuver the city, taking out pockets of partisans as they could, but it was like they multiplied with every death. Grand Admiral Thrawn stood in the Imperial Command Center in Jedha City, watching the conflict play out alongside Director Krennic. Lord Vader was with the pair previously, but left to tend to other business he would not elaborate on. As the Grand Admiral watched, Krennic couldn't help but boast about the efforts of his troops. There's absolutely no hope for these fools. They were expecting to rob us of Kyber. Now they'll get a lot more than that. Krennic seemed to have been waiting for a response from Thrawn, but the Chiss was instead poring over the battle feed as it came in real time. He read every single report, cross-checking it with the route map used for the Kyber shipments, and something glared at him. He turned to the director, who still held much confidence. Director Krennic, I regret to inform you, but it seems these partisans have a much different target than you expected. What are you on about, Grand Admiral? These rebels have been robbing the Empire of Kyber for months. Their attention isn't going to shift so suddenly. That's the issue. These reports indicate that the Kyber shipments have remained untouched for the most part. They actually indicate the partisans are headed here, to the command center. Krennic turned to Thrawn, almost doing a double take, as he contemplated the news. A new transmission was received from the battlefield.
Director Krennic! We spotted Saw Gerrera in Sector A3! He's moving towards the command center!
There stood a moment of silence before Krennic finally made a decision. Send my Gauss Squadron into battle and prepare my shuttle for launch to Scarif immediately. I'm finished on this disgusting rock. With that, Krennic handed full command to Grand Admiral Thrawn, who quickly saw to it to fortify all routes leading to the command center. Soon, a stalemate finally began, to which Thrawn decided to close off the city entirely, trapping the partisans and squashing them where they stood. However, much to his displeasure, he has now received new reports from his fleet up above. A small rebel detachment is dropping out of hyperspace. Captain Bronson, I want a report. What's happening? Multiple rebel fighters and a frigate have arrived, Grand Admiral. I'm sending a report now. Thrawn received the report and for the first time in a while, felt a genuine shock. Among the ships was something he never expected to see. The Ghost. The ship had returned back from the dead, and the Grand Admiral could only say one thing. Syndulla.